Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. We want to solve this absolute value equation. How to solve the absolute value equation? To solve the equation, in general, we have two situations. The inside part is positive or zero. The inside part is negative. Then we can drop the absolute value sign to solve a quadratic equation to get solutions. What is the difficult part? Difficult part, we need to check the condition. Sometimes we find the answer. The answer may be not the real solution to satisfy this absolute value equation. The difficult part is to solve the inequality, to find the region, the intervals, such that the inside part is bigger than or equal to zero or less than zero. From the left-hand side, we know that the right-hand side must be bigger than or equal to zero. Here, the absolute value is always bigger than or equal to zero. Here, they are equal. Therefore, x must be less than or equal to 3. That's the region, that's the interval. We need to find a solution. All solutions must be satisfied this condition, x less than or equal to 3. Factoring the inside part of the absolute value, we have x minus 1 times x plus 5. From this graph of x squared plus 4x minus 5, we can find when x is bigger than or equal to 1, less than or equal to negative 5. X squared plus 4x minus 5 is bigger than or equal to 0. The graph is above x-axis. When the graph is below the x-axis, we can see all x values are between negative 5 and 1. When the inside part is bigger than or equal to 0, from the parabola graph, we have x must be bigger than or equal to 1, or x less than or equal to negative 5. Bigger than or equal to 0 implies x squared plus 4x minus 5 equals 6 minus 2x. This means we can drop the absolute value. This is quadratic equation. We use the quadratic formula to solve it to find two answers. The question is, are the two answers satisfy all required conditions? We need to check one by one. The first one, the first condition, negative 3 plus 2 square root of 5, certainly is less than or equal to 3. That's true. And the second, we need to check one of the two conditions. The first condition here, x is bigger than or equal to 1, it is true. Therefore, this is the answer. Now we need to check the second answer. Negative 3 minus 2 square root of 5, which is negative, certainly less than or equal to 3. That's true. And this is also less than or equal to negative 5. This condition is true. Therefore, the second solution is the real solution. Let's consider the second situation when the inside part is negative. The inside part is negative implies x must be between negative 5 and 1. From that graph, we have this result. Therefore, when we solve this equation, we need to check the answer. If the answer is satisfy this condition and this condition at the same time, because the inside part is negative, when we drop the absolute value sign, we have to put a negative in front of x squared plus 4x minus 5. Simplify this equation. We have x squared plus 2x plus 1 equals 0. From this equation, we have the answer, x equals negative 1. We want to check if x equals negative 1 satisfy the two conditions here. X equals negative 1, certainly less than or equal to 3. And it is also between negative 5 and 1. Therefore, x equals negative 3 is the third solution. All three solutions are solutions by checking. That's all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.